Let's kick off. What is this? It's a noise. Listen out carefully.
We're beginning with K.
Yeah, a klaxon.
Oh! In a strange sort of way, pop just ate itself, didn't it?
A klaxon gave a klaxon. We call it the klaxon. It's not actually a klaxon.
So is that a brand name? Like the Tannoy or Hoover?
Yeah, absolutely right. Just like Tannoy or Hoover.
So what is it, an alarm?
It's basically a siren, a noise, an alarm noise, exactly. Klaxon has a very specific sound. It belongs to a company called Lovell McConnell Manufacturing. They were first fitted to cars, and they were the first electric thing ever to be attached to an automobile. The klaxon.
So they needed an alarm before a light.
So the sound we heard was just call it some general word, but technically it's not a klaxon. Now, automobiles, America, the land of the free, the land of the automobile. You can imagine that in places like Pennsylvania, they must have welcomed them when they arrived, yes?
No.
No. It's the right answer. Alan, you're really getting the hang of
this. I've played this before. To intuit.
You would be astounded by the Farmers Anti-Automobile Association of Pennsylvania with its list of impractical requirements for motorists. Automobiles travelling on country roads at night must send up a rocket every mile. And then wait 10 minutes for the road to clear. The driver may then proceed with caution, blowing his horn and shooting off Roman candles. If the driver of an automobile sees a team of horses approaching, he is to stop, pull to one side of the road, almost cover his machine with a blanket or dust cover, which is painted or coloured to blend into the scenery. In case a horse is unwilling to pass an automobile on the road, the driver of the car must take the machine apart as rapidly as possible and conceal the parts in the bushes. They really didn't want motor cars in Pennsylvania. Honking the horn, is that a sensible, safe thing to do? Does it avoid accidents?
Oh, it'll frighten the horses.
Well, obviously, let's assume we're talking about now when there aren't any.
Wouldn't it raise aggression? Hearing a loud noise makes you probably release adrenaline, and then your instincts would be flawed, I would have thought.
I think you're absolutely right.
Have you ever driven in Italy? I've been on tour in Italy, and the word go is die in Italy. Die, die, die. You're 19, I'm not a driver.
No, but you're absolutely right. There is no evidence that using the horn contributes to safety.
There's something interesting with police sirens, isn't there? Because it's two different notes, and the reason is, if you hear one note for a long time, you can't tell where it's coming from.
That's exactly right. You genuinely can't tell. In front of me, or is it behind me? You just don't know. In America, they have a very good rule when you hear a siren on the road.
Yeah.
You just simply stop driving.
Yeah.
And go and have a meal.
And then. But it actually somehow works out incredibly well, and the emergency vehicle just.
But they have wider roads.
They have much wider roads, of course. Yeah. But it does work. Fantastic. And everybody does it.
See which of the emergency services it is, and then decide.
It's only an ambulance, they don't count, or it's only a fire.
What is that, then?
It's the police. There's something sort of vaguely right-wing about it.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.